Jack, you've been working for over 23 years on toilets across the globe. From your experience, please tell us, how can cleanliness solve the problem of health and economic crisis of a country?
Yeah, thank you. So basically, I founded the World Toilet Organization 20 years ago. This year is our 20th anniversary. And at that time, people were very shy to talk about toilets. And yet we have to go to the toilet 6 to 8 times a day. So sanitation, hygiene, today has become the highest awareness in the history of mankind. Every single person is worried about COVID. So they are washing their hands. They're keeping their distance. They're wearing their mask. And they are very clean. We need to keep this habit and use this to leverage on the behavioral change. In the Swachh Bharat, we have created so many toilets, but now we have to promote that people will clean them, people will maintain them and use them for their own safety. Toilet is the cheapest medicine in the world. You don't wait until people are sick like now with this pandemic. In the Singapore journey, when I was growing up in 1965, we became an independent country. And the country was very, very poor. And the first thing to do is, because we have no money, to build hospital and clinics and employ doctors and nurses. So we clean up the river, clean up the street, clean up the toilet, get everybody to be clean. Then immediately you save a lot of healthcare costs and you have a lot of productive workers. Then we attract the foreign investor and create a lot of jobs. Then, of course, we build public housing, all that. But the very interesting thing about clean, which is very similar to the Swachh Bharat project in recent years, the clean campaign in Singapore extend from cleaning the river, toilet and street to cleaning the mindset of the people. And we clean up corruption. The country is now very trusted because there's no corruption. And we also clean up the mafia. When I was a child, we have a lot of secret society, a lot of triads, and today there's no such thing. So clean is both physically and spiritually clean. And when you are able to do that, you create trust, you create health, you create economic viability, jobs, and quality of life.
That's very, very inspiring, sir. All the work that you've done for various communities across the globe, thank you so much.